Okay, now I'm back. I went and got my CDs. And I needed a cookie. Sorry. Already time for a snack at least. I ate breakfast, came outside. Yeah, I didn't get up till about 2:30 or 3 or something in the afternoon. That's why I'm out here at night doing the stuff I should be doing in the daytime. I don't really have anything that's a problem new enough. This is Debian 7.4. It's the newest Debian I have on the CD. See if this will open this time. Probably not. Okay, I'll get the key. I'll get the secret key for the CD drive. You know what that key is? It's a paper clip. This one happens to be bent into a, I don't know if you can see it, but it's bent into a shape for something in particular. I don't know what it was, but it, just as long as you got enough straight of it straight, you can stick it in that tiny little hole, push the button, and then give a little pressure on in there against, make sure you hit, if you go down below the little kind of a button, I guess it is, in there, then it won't open. It's not really a button, it's part of the mechanical mechanism. What you're doing is you're giving it a little push because it's stuck. I think I hit the button and made it go back in. But that'll make it work. Okay. But I just remembered, I'm pretty sure there's no hard drive in that machine. So I brought this 30 gig out in case I decided to put it in there. It's not seeing my, let me just wait. Yeah, let me turn it off, turn it back on, then maybe it'll see the CD drive. Sometimes they do that. Some of them are worse about that than others, especially when you have to force them open, that sometimes they get their reading and everything out of whack. But I've got a cookie to eat here while I'm waiting on things. Some CDs that were written in other, you know, they're all written in different machines over the years, so you won't even read in some of these drives. Whoop. I'm going to hit F1 to repeat boot sequence and just see what it does. It does nothing. I probably have to unplug it and plug it back in. Now the drive is working. Hang on, let me get a drink. Okay, I'm going to hard shut it down and then unplug it and plug it back in. I don't think it has a... Yeah, this one... Wait. No, this one don't have a power switch. So you gotta, that'll work sometimes, reset whatever in there that needs to be reset that ain't working. Something in the hardware. If that don't make it work, I'll have to try a different CD. Getting a bit aggravated. I don't think it can read this CD. Is that a DVD? You can't read DVDs. That's a CD drive. That's a CD. I did see Fedora 23 net install. That's what I originally installed. There's no sense in that, though. What I originally installed the server that was on here with. Evidently, because that's what it's, what else have I got? Well, let's just put that in there because it should read it. See if that's, pretty sure that's why I put it on there. failed test in IBM. Oh, I had some pencil markings on there. I thought I should read it. But loads in DVD. Passed test, red black BIOS store. So it failed the test on this drive. This just must be a drive that's not reading well. What is that? I'm not sure what kind of drive it is. So, sometimes when you write them in one drive, some drives don't write in a way that's compatible with others. Especially if when you wrote with a DVD drive or something. Started magic. I booted it to something. Just this remote bootable. I just don't have anything that's actually. I don't want to install anything now, I don't think, because it's just going to take forever. And if I'm going to work on something, I need to work on the good ones. And, you know, the new server in my room. I've got 3 NIC cards I bought in December that I need to test in Mom's machines to make sure they're going to work before I run out of time to send it back. Since it's Christmas, they let you have a little more time on returns on Amazon. I noticed. I hope I haven't passed it. I don't think so. I really don't remember what would or won't boot in here. Maybe part of magic will boot. Another thing boots up on stuff. Bring my other USB stick, the one that has, but it's not 32-bit either. It's just flat one. It says half. Oh, it's not reading my drives. I made my CDs. That was a rewritable CD, which sometimes they are a little more picky about being read. Now I've got the USB stick in there, but I'm sure it's just going to say it's a. It doesn't say it's 64-bit, but I'm pretty sure it is. It'll boot the USB. Yeah. That's 28. I don't want 28 anymore, so I can reformat this. But I didn't want to spend time doing that when I need to do other work inside. I didn't even have to be out here waiting on the charger. Just I tend to forget for hours, and I don't want to leave that battery charger on there. I do have. I don't know why I didn't try it before, but you know, on the Android, you can talk to it and tell it to do things. Well, I knew it had an alarm in there, and I couldn't even remember what app to use or whatever. So I talked to the Google thing and said, set alarm. It says, okay, what time? Told it, and it did it. So I used that for set it for an hour. Now I'm doing 30 minutes. And I did. I was walking back, you know, going to my room, coming back out here, and when I came back out, it did go off. I heard how it works. That's the first time I've used it, but a long time ago, and I did it the fiddly way, instead of talking to it. Well, maybe it won't boot part the new part of Magic. Here's an older version of part of Magic. It's not that new. It's from 2013. But that was 6. Part of Magic 6.6. This is 5.9. Look like it's. I think that drive decided it don't want to work. It does work, I think. Unless I unplugged it again by accident. I did that one other time when I was messing with the hard drives. Maybe I've unplugged the power to it or something. And didn't even realize it. Or did it and forgot. Get that CD out of there. I'll be looking for it. Some machines won't. Well, it's got power or it wouldn't be coming in and out. I could have unplugged the IDE, but I don't know why I would do that. It may just be wanting to quit. Been sitting running as a server for at least 2 years, and you know I never just let it run. So hard drive, that 30 gig hard drive, I don't think it has enough. I don't know what it has on it, actually. Of course, it wouldn't have an operating system for this machine. This audio cable somewhere where I won't lose it. Let's tie it to this. I've got a twisty on the end of it. It's got a red Ethernet cable going. I don't know where it's going. Oh, it's going over here into this machine. So it's a 25 foot, but it has a broken clip, so I don't like to use it. You know, leave it in a machine. I just use it temporarily, usually like a laptop or something. You got a button here that's pretty convenient, but it doesn't always let go. It's gone from way over there. There now. I think I can get to it. I didn't want to have to unplug everything if I didn't have to. I never did plug it, turn my sound back on. I'll turn it on. I mean, it'll make a noise when I plug in the cable, but. There's two places to put drives in here. And up here, this one you can get to from the front. Yeah, everything's plugged into the CD drive just like it should be. You can get to this other one from the front. Well, let's make sure that it's not loosened up on the motherboard or something. Show you what I'm doing. Light, let's see if you can see. Yeah, we can see. The light's not plugged in. I unplugged it a while ago. Yeah. There's the. They're good. Here's the power and the to the CD drive. And then this is where the hard drive goes. But, well, oh yeah, you just take the front cover off and then you slide it in, which is fine. No big deal. But, oh, there's the IDE cable right there for it. But I just got to thinking, This is actually kind of harder, but this one you can get to from the front. It leans forward, and you can't hop swap them, but you can swap them without opening the side of the machine. I think I'll do that because I might change my mind about what drive I want in it. It's kind of fiddly to do, but I'll leave the side off anyway until I'm done. Yeah, I'm not going to mess with that drive anymore, that CD drive. But I'm going to put this... Where am I? There we are. Okay. Yeah. It's really hard to see what I'm showing in this preview in here. There we go. There's a button on the back of the machine. Push it forward and then that just comes right on. That's a pretty cool feature on this machine. Except for it's real, those cables, you need, they used to make cables that were real popular for a while, and I have one, but I think it's got bad connections. They were round instead of flat, and they had IDEs on them like this, and connectors on them. Or I'd use it. I still have it. I don't think I'm even using it now. I'm not using it because I think it has a bad connection. Let's see now. Where's that hard drive? Let's see what it's set on with the jumpers on. No telling. This is a 30 gig master. Oh, this came in my Celeron. My Dell Celeron that got killed by lightning. Okay. Oh, okay. Master. Two of them going straight in a row. And it is on slave or something. Cable select. Yeah. Actually, cable select is good on most. I can't remember. Yeah, this machine should be good for cable select. So. Oh, the single. It's so hard to get this oriented. Single cable select is single, double, then cable select. Single, double, cable select. I'm going to leave it on cable select. I think that'll be fine. And I mean, I have to take it all the way out to change it, but no, I won't. Because it goes in here like this. I'm going to try to put it in so that I can plug it in easily. You can put this in, especially a thin drive. This thin drive, I think you can put it in either way you want. Oh, that's going to kind of be in the way. So I'm going to try it this way. This little plastic caddy here. It has little ears that fit in there. It has little ears in it I'll just call them ears. Tabs that right there that fit in the holes where the screws would go. This is a real thin drive. The fatter drives won't go but one way. So sometimes it's really hard to get the cable lined up. And if you mess with, if you force those things, they will get out of their place, and then you gotta put them back. I want it to be that way and that way. Okay, let's try it this way then. This will go in either way. Yeah, this is kind of harder than just putting it in there. Put a couple of screws in it. So I may end up changing my mind. Let's see. I just thought, yeah, it's actually not easier. Getting the side off is a bit of a pain, but... Plenty in my room. Okay, now I can get to it. And I want to turn, I really want it turned that way. So if I can plug it in easy enough, I'll leave it like this. I don't want to go in there that way. It came out, just like I was talking about. Tab came out of its spot. I don't know why it did that. Sometimes you've got to take the drive all the way back out. Be a little hard to show, so down here, so I'm not going to try. It's kind of neat, but it's not a real robust system. I got to not use it, if I remember. I'm remembering. Turns into be a pain, but I think it would be okay if I get it in here. Once I get it in here, where's my power? It's got to go somewhere so I can put it in. Oh, you got that? You want IDE? I've got SATAN IDE in on this thing. Which is nice if you want to, you know, do either kind of drive. I think I'll go ahead and plug it in. Put that back in there. Hopefully it won't be in the way. Now, if this will reach, yeah, but not actually implemented all that well. That's what they always say. Good idea, but poorly implemented. All the hotshots on the internet would say that. I would guess I would have to agree in this case. About the best way. When you hear people say, you know how it is, just like, you know, before the internet, you always talk like the people you hang out with. Well, I hang out with people on YouTube, but I don't know them and they don't know me. Sometimes I make a comment once in a while and they answer me. Does that count as being friends? Probably not. I call it real life and the internet. Real life game is when you actually see people in real life. And you know them in real life. Okay. Now, it's not always the best thing to. Well, let's don't shut the lid until we know whether or not it's going to work. Now, let's do it because I can't plug all my cables up without shoving it back around. This is not square or not rectangle. It throws your eyes into a loop when you look at it and try to size it back around. Let's do it last. I'm using all my longer cables, you know, audio cables in the house, so I don't have the right one that's a good length. let's see what we got. We'll just turn it on and see if it has to boot up to something. What's it doing? I got sidetracked with putting my tools back where they belong in my toolbox. I didn't do anything. I guess I didn't hold the button in long enough. No operating system. It's doing the same exact thing as it was before. Okay. So unless I want to rewrite me a USB stick, I ain't booting none of these. How long do I have? I don't have a clock unless I have a computer running. You can see the time on this. I don't know if there's time on here while you're making a video or not. Tells you how much space you got left. That's cool. Yeah, there's not a time. If there's time in there, there's some things that my rubber bands are in the way of that hold this thing together. Oh, there it is. 7:18 p.m. So no, it's not time to take the charger off. It should be at about 7:30. I don't know why it won't boot. I bet you there's a CD it'll boot to, but I can't think of any reason why it would actually help me boot it to a CD. Let's look at what I got here. I'll leave it running trying to boot and see. OS 16 might work. Now the drive program. Yeah, when I used CDs all the time, it was before, I started doing it before, you know, before machines booted to USB, or the newest ones did, maybe. I don't think they did at all when I, in 2005 is when I started learning Linux, and so this is like Fedora 19, that was Fedora 16, and this is the gamers. That's a DVD anyway. XBMC. A lot of these are live systems. Yeah, that one's live. But I don't want XBMC on there anyway. Ultimate Boot CD. Iron's Boot CD, that'd be fun. With Mini XP, what would be one of the things I could use on there. Iron's Boot CD 4. I don't see the version. Sometimes I didn't get the bro. Where it is. No. 4.0. 11? This is 11.0. Is it really the newest one? I'll try that, I guess. Could be that I miswrote that and it's supposed to be 1.1. Oh, 11.14. And that one does not say. It says the date. Oh, okay. 6/20/11, 10/30/10. So that's older. We have a date on there. That's some other. Of course, just because of the date doesn't necessarily mean it's what will work on this machine. Oh, the way this this thing is working. I can't get anything in and out of it unless I do it like that. There we go. Yeah. Sometimes you just can't, you just don't want to cooperate and you gotta make it. So, I almost hit the power button. Now it's gonna really be out of whack. It shouldn't read for nothing now. Power it off. I think that the drive is just not reading. I have a drive cleaner which could possibly help. A little CD that you put in there. It doesn't have to read it to clean it. As long as it's spinning, it'll clean it. But I didn't know that this thing was acting up like that, the drive. I don't think it's anything that... I think if it, the drive isn't working right, that's not a problem then. Sometimes if you power down when it's trying to read, it'll help. Sometimes it'll jack it up. I should go on BIOS and make sure it can see that hard drive and everything. Let's see if we can get into the BIOS. See, I think it'd be F12. Try to sell off to the side where you can see the screen a little bit. Yeah. Get that thing out of there. I'm real prone to forgetting those things in there. It's really acting up. Once it gets to where you have to force it in and out, you usually have to mess with it. Well, not mess with it, but just don't bother it for a while. Turning it on and off and stuff. It's almost like there's something really hung up. Tell me about whether or not I can really use this thing or not. Okay, why is it still doing that? That's not normal for this machine. Oh, there we go. Inner setup. Now. Well, the battery didn't go down. A 10819. UUID system summary 2.53 GHz, 2,016 MB of memory. That's 2 GB of memory, 333 MHz. Intel R865G graphics chip. It's only about 32 MB, I think. Fan 1 not operating, fan 2 operating, disk A disabled. Yeah, there's no floppy in it. Let's see, it doesn't say, it doesn't see any IDE drives, period. Why? Okay, let's look over here. Automatic PS2, disk drive disabled, serial port enabled, USB enabled, parallel ports enabled, video 32 MB, graphic aperture 256 MB. Oh, so if I had a video card in it, it could have 256 MB. Parallel, enable, okay. Parallel ATA and A, both. Enabled, serial ATA, enabled. Native mode operation, automatic. Okay, so that should be good. It's that primary secondary both. Well, we want both then. Audio setup enabled, network setup enabled, Pixie boot disabled, Pixie base code enabled, MAC address not available. Startup. Keyboard num lock. Let's see what this is. Oh, okay. CD, USB. IDE CD, then USB, and then USB CD-ROM, and then IDE 01 and 2, and then 3, 4, all IDE CD. I think this is the machine where when you try to add stuff back, it doesn't work. Let's see, use the up and down keys and select. Up and down, F and R specify the device fixed or removable. Oh, okay. And then excludes forward slash includes, and it doesn't work. This is a machine. Once you take something out of there, that, see, I used to be full, and I took a couple out trying to, you know, change it up. And to what I thought it needed. It's just, it says all IDE CD, which wouldn't hurt to be in there. I think that's the last one I took out. But like IDE 3, 4, and 5 you don't need. USB floppy disk, no. PCI LAN, well, you actually might want that in there if you're going to use Pixie boot, but PXE, I think it is, PXE, whatever, I call it Pixie boot. Let's see, shift 1 enables or disables a device, shift 1. And that doesn't work, doesn't matter. You can, I think even when you disable or enable, you do it up here. It's something gone wonky with it. I've seen it work, but it doesn't always work. Primary, automatic, or error. One, primary, automatic, or error. Automatic, three, so what? Oh. That was not what I wanted. I hit three, error. Startup sequence, automatic. Primary. Oh, okay. That works. Put it on automatic. Maybe that'll make it work. Yeah, these numbers down here, I have not noticed those before. I didn't pay good attention. Now it's back to LAN. IDE 1, 2, 3. See if we can add. Let's see. Maybe it'll let me add something now. If it's on automatic, maybe it'll do it, because it's not seeing anything. I'm going to leave it on automatic. Maybe that's how it belongs, and I whacked it out the last time I tried to fix it. On keyboard. Keyboard speed fast. List operation enabled. Keyboard list operation disabled. It could be enabled, but I'm not going to do that now. It could be for a server, though. Self-test quick. Enable logo. Keys. Option keys. Enabled. Legacy. I think I like it like that. Let's see, controls with single prompts, plus logo screen. Normal will prompt for either for the enter key and display a menu. Yeah, that confuses me. I'm used to hitting legacy will go F1, F11, or F12. That's the way I like it. That's what I'm used to. And some of them, the newer machines still do that, and they don't call it legacy. So I don't know why. For them, it's legacy. Enable the menu prompt, automatic start, sequence enabled. Okay, advanced. Have parity enabled, plug and play system yes, legacy free disabled. Okay, well, I don't want to disable that. I can see that. Limit CPU ID, limits the numbers to 3, that's fine. I don't want all that being broadcast. Quiet fan. Actually, I want that on normal because it's out here in the garage now. Well, it might go back in my room, though. If it's out here in the garage running, well, I wasn't planning on leaving it. I put it back on quiet because it's not summer. I'm actually actually planning on bringing the Net Pro Max out here, and it's going to go out there, and I'll probably bring this back in my room unless it ain't going to work right. I may have decided it's worn out. Post protected area. Recovery images. Oh, for the diagnostics and service utilities. No user or software initiated changes allowed. Normal change allowed, but contents are hidden from OS. And then disable visible to OS as normal disk space. Why would you do that? Recovery images and just, Well, I'm going to leave it like it is because I don't think that has a thing to do with it booting. Adapter ROM security. Yes, okay, we don't want that. I think that blocks the BIOS. Okay, we don't want IDE controller enabled, right, protected, disabled. Movable devices, not requiring a password, yeah, no passwords. Remote administration, disabled. Set password, no. Make sure all that's on, okay. Now the, I want all this on automatic, but can be. IRQ, okay. Advanced configuration and power interface, ACPI. Well, that should be alright. I didn't change it. I didn't need to learn that, so I just know that. I don't know what I really know about is you get a lot of, and Linux, newer Linux distros say it doesn't work with an error, but it doesn't matter the way the machine runs. It's Advanced Configuration Power Interface, ACPI, and it's on IRQ9, which I believe is set automatically, and that's usually the best way to leave them. If you start messing with IRQs, you will really usually just cause yourself a world of hurt. You used to have to do that in the older machines, manually, it wasn't automatic. Or you did to get certain PCI cards to work. HPS standby mode. Select which power level your system goes to during standby. If S1 is selected, power, this is on S3, is maintained to all devices, but all processor activity is halted. If S3 is selected, power is maintained only for the main memory. Exit from the S3 state may not be supported by all installed adapters. I think it should be, whoops, how do you change it? Oh, there we go. Hit enter, and then I think it should be S1, really. Let's see. If the processor, I probably did that because I didn't want it to delay it answering, you know, requests for web pages. But I didn't want the processor to go to sleep.